I wouldn't miss it.
Yeah, this one.
Hello, Commissioner Bell. Is this the right meeting room?
Which one are you here for?
The public participation?
On Landfill or Point?
Yes.
This is it.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Oh, was it you?
Which one?
In distress. Final. Couple more on the way. They can make it through the summer.
This heat is horrible.
No, it's not bad in here at all.
Ms. Tisdale, how are you?
I'm doing well, Mr. Jarrard, thank you.
Hey, man. How are you?
Well, I'm fine. No, I can do this right.
Do this? Okay. Good to see you.
Where
you
been
hiding
yourself?
You
remember me? Yes, I do.
Yeah,
I remember
good.
You.
Okay. All right.
Really good.
Yeah, okay. I didn't know if you did or not.
I sure did. Is Mr. Henderson?
I haven't talked to him. I don't know if I talked to him or not. He's so hard to get on the phone with him, you know?
It's hard to get him on the phone.
Well, get him on the phone. Then once you get him on, you can't get him off. Yeah.
Start with whoever would like to start.
you can, we, it's a small enough group, we don't need to be real formal about it, but, yeah. And I'm gonna just make some notes here.
I actually have prepared and sent an email today to the planning commission. I'll go give you a copy of that. That addresses that map, which is, I'm sorry, I'm Lee Huntley, I live right across the street.
If it helps, I've got these maps, and again, there's a small enough group here, there's no, I mean, we don't need to stand be too formal, we can stand around the maps.
Works for me. If you've got a area map.
This one.
Another side, it's driving myself. Okay, this is the bar.
This,
bar
yeah, this is Old Federal.
Okay, then I'm right in here. I'm directly across the street from, I'm not sure which cell, wherever it was currently in operation. Directly across the street.
So you're right in here?
It's on the corner.
And you live on Old Federal?
On the corner, Old Federal.
Okay.
Can somebody explain what we're looking at? I mean, you just help me to orient me.
Well, this is a topographical. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that shows the topo of the borrow area, the existing landfill, the cells, permitted cells. I don't know if they're all active cells, but permitted cells.
Got it.
These are the adjacent property owners. Here's the Forsyth County landfill, Solomon's. Eagle Point owns that one. So what we're trying to find is kind of where Blanton would be to give us a reference point.
Very
good.
Blanton is approximately in here.
Very well. Yeah, let's go ahead and clean it out.
That's way too long.
There you go.
It's going to be tough to write in here. Now what I did, I've always been concerned about all of these houses, residents are on ground water, well water.
Right.
There's no municipal supply. Being concerned, many years ago I had my water tested by UL Laboratories. But not knowing what to look test for, it gets very expensive, as you probably know. Well, mine came back okay, but that's only because I just had a basic test of not knowing to look for any VOCs now and all that stuff. But
VOC is what?
Volatile organic compound.
VOC. Okay.
And the reason I mention it is because it came up in this report. It's on the other side of that little map I gave. I called EPD and had them give me some reports. I had to describe because it didn't give a definition. This is a page out of the groundwater report from EPD describing, and the other side is the map, certain contaminants that are found in certain wells. And the name, if you look here, it's kind of hard to read.
GWC.
You can see A4A, yeah. 4 and 5. Mm-hmm. And you can see the direction of the underground water flow, which is right there on the right.
Right.
If you flip it back over, what I point out in my email.
Help me with this now. Where is
this? This is the old county landfill. So this is this corner. This is this. Just like it.
That's
yes. Okay. So these groundwater flow maps, arrows, are actually showing how the water flows into, in two directions, into this property. Yes. Exactly. And point out on the other side is these
wells are specifically named, okay, as being, and you have to read the whole thing, but the plume is what they refer to as a contaminated region. And those wells are the ones named, as I just pointed out, as being the ones in that line of flow containing VOCs.
Okay. And your concern is that this soil?
My concern, in a nutshell, is that it should not be disturbed. And ultimately, it should be cleaned up, okay? However, we don't know what contaminants are. I don't think anyone has a good handle what the amount of contamination and what it's going to take to clean it up. In the meantime, we prefer it just be left alone until that can be determined. It's pretty evident to us, and this is another explanation, we have a very strong belief this is at least this area closest to landfill. Maybe this area was not as contaminated as but we very strong belief this is contaminated. Maybe just the
first. I'm going to tell everybody here, now I'm not an engineer. I have to learn these just like you guys do. And I did have them give me a cutaway view because I was concerned about, are they digging down or what are they doing exactly? And these right here give us an idea of the high spots that they're going to be removing. They are going to be digging down in this one here, which is CC, which is looking this way. So it's going to be, this is the road, this would be the back parcel, the road, the back parcel. So if that gives us an idea, I know that there's concerns about them digging down into, Pete was telling me that they're digging down to within 3 feet of the groundwater. I've got to verify that and check to see what it is, because he just brought it up.
That's what they said.
Okay, so we need to look into that.
That's our concern, is that they are digging that low, 75 acres pretty much for 15 years now. Ask for a 15 years only, what is that?
I checked on that today as well.
So what are they saying?
They're not 73 saying. Acres is that parcel. They're going to be affecting 41 acres, and it's for 6 years. 2012 to 2018 is what.
Well, they told us 15.
That's totally different than they said at the last meeting.
The meeting they told us 15 years.
Well, this was given to me from our director of planning.
And they changed their plan again. Because we had a public meeting on it, and Cindy was also present, and they told us 15 years is what they would dig for three. And they told us the whole acreage would, it was, 73.69 or something like
73.69.
That. 73.69. Okay, it would be 3 foot above the groundwater. And what my concern is in that area, because I gotta be careful about what I say, right. Is our county owns a landfill that is contaminated. We all know that. All Forsyth County knows this. I mean, nothing that's been hid for years, okay? It's just not been spoken about. And what we're concerned about, they go in there digging, they're going to cause it to run to us, and we need water out there, and nobody doesn't want to bring us water out there, and except for bring it from another county, that they want to do it on us homeowners' expense, and we're not doing it.
We just can't do it. What expense?
On getting water out there. When we try to get water before, we would all have to pay for it.
You have to pay for the water.
We have to pay to get it there.
What she's saying is that yes. They run the pipelines through, but if it's hooked up to our house,
you got to pay for the meter.
We got to pay for it being hooked into our house and everything.
Mm-hmm. We have to pay for the hookup. That's right. That's right. Out of our
pocket. Do you live on Plant Lane as well?
No, I live right above.
Okay.
I live on the Yellow Creek
road. Right. And help me a little bit. Do you live in the same area, same place? How about you?
I'm on Plant Lane.
You're on Plant Lane. You're on where do you live?
With him.
I'm Blanton. Yeah, you guys live on the left. Yeah, right.
Okay, can you tell me this? Is this is what I'm concerned about. The county allowing this area to be disturbed, knowing that they already have issues out there that's going to cost the taxpayers big money. And we all know that.
You talking about the old landfill?
Yes, I am. The one that
this is a zoning. The difficulty.
It's adjusted to that contaminated property. That zoning.
The difficulty that we run into on things like this is we're not today. While the old landfill may or may not affect, again, I'm not an engineer, and I'm not going to say whether it does or not. But we have a property owner in a business that certainly their rights don't trump anybody else's, but they're not messing with the old plant bill.
No, but they're wanting to take right what's suggested to.
Well, and again, I'm not an engineer. Has the soil been tested?
No, because that's
now, what that brings you into right there, Patrick, is your landfill's out of compliance, okay? Hadn't been in compliance in over 12 years.
Right.
And you need that situation there needs to be tucked here out before this is tucked here out. Because y'all out of compliance, y'all supposed to go chase that contamination down where it goes to. Y'all haven't done it the first yet.
And that can, and when
you got test wells to find out where that stuff goes and where it stops and starts at. And if you go digging that dirt up over there in that place there, knowing just as good well that could be contamination under that dirt, you're going to change the groundwater direction. You could change the groundwater direction. It's like we told you on the first landfill that didn't work there neither, you know, but we're telling you again that, you know, just don't make us be right twice.
Well, what if that area, you've been involved in this a lot, what if it were tested, the ground was tested to see if it's contaminated? Would that be reasonable?
Well, that's what the EPD is working on now. They've done all of that. They've fact, they didn't see y'all left.
So if the EPD is working on that and we find that the soil's not contaminated, is there still an issue in your mind?
What about the water?
Well, sorry?
What about the water?
What?
Do we know the fact of the water?
The groundwater, is it?
Where the groundwater
no,
is going to be. I'm going to tell you, I can't answer that. I'm not even going to begin to because I'm not a hydrologist. I spend a lot of time with this stuff.
That's the basic question in my mind is, will the counties, what county willing to perform these tests to get everybody satisfied that there is no hazard?
Well, I have
now
to tell you, I don't know what any of you guys have been told, but I'm not willing to let anything that's going to be dangerous to anybody. Okay, I mean, you have my word on that. I'm not sitting here saying that I'm presenting on behalf of Eagle Point or Advanced Disposal because I'm not. I don't know what you've been told. I suspect that's not what you've been told, but I'm going to tell you, if it's not healthy or if there's proof that there's a problem, then we're not going to do it.
Well,
and I can
proof.
Tell you that.
I have proof right here in this man's hands.
Well, that's a different issue, Ms.
Why? Because it's mine and it's not theirs yet. But tell me this. If this same thing happens to my neighbors here, are you going to protect them like you have me and my husband and my family today and the last 6 years? No, you're not. So don't lie to them. Just be honest with them.
Well, I can't refute any of that. I can tell you that they don't take care of you.
They
don't have both sides of the story, is what I can tell.
Yes, they know my side.
They know your side.
That's right.
They don't know our side. They don't know the talks that we
have. I have your side right there in that paperwork.
Well, have you shared it with everybody?
No, because I know better. I've done been told by you not to.
What you say about
you told me not to discuss anything about what was going on in the situation
with
me. You closed the meeting.
But what I'm telling you is your concerns that the county will or will not do something.
I'm very concerned because they haven't yet.
Well, I'm going to tell you
this. Listen, well, wait,
hey,
back up.
Terry, let's talk.
I'm just
I've heard enough of that. I've heard enough. We have proof the county has done nothing, okay? You received a letter here no less than a week ago that's showing you out of compliance, showing that you haven't done nothing, okay? And what you have done was high fives, okay?
I can't because it's a public record.
Well, and I'm going to tell you right now, if you said just a few minutes ago, if you test the other, that land over, if they see contamination over there, maybe they not. But when they go moving that dirt and you change the direction of that water, it very well can draw it there.
So maybe there's a
just like somebody's little well drew a little bit over there to them,
so
you know?
Maybe there's a mechanism to check on it. You know, I will say.
No, you're playing with a stick of dynamite, is what I'm saying you're doing when you mess with that dirt over there.
Well, I'm not saying we are or not. I'm not arguing with you about it.
Well, I'm not arguing either. I'm just telling
you. I will tell you that the efforts that the county has made, I believe, have been good faith. These people don't know both sides of the story. And they can't know both sides of the story because I can't tell them. You can tell them. You can tell them what the county offered you and let them decide if it's fair. I can't. I'm going to tell you, I think the county has tried to be fair and tried to work through this, and we will continue to try to work through it because I am concerned about it. And I am concerned about the people that live out there. I have been out there and I fought to get y'all's road paved when nobody else could get it done. I do care and I do listen. And I'm excited.
Wait a minute now. On that road paving deal, all that is a scratch your back deal there, Patrick. Because
for who?
I ain't going to say no names, but let's say You had so much money to do roads with and you didn't use it. Someone calls you up and says, will you do my road?
That road wasn't gonna get done because of some other issues.
Okay, here's another situation. I mean, as far as, you know, like we just said here, these people here have a right to protect their farms and their land just
absolutely
as well as
right
everyone else,
you're
including you.
Right.
So if you come on their property and you test for contamination and you find it, what are you gonna do to help them? Can you answer that one?
Not really.
I didn't think so.
And I can't answer it because I don't know the answer.
Who does? I've been waiting for a long time, spend thousands and thousands of dollars for that answer, and I ain't got it yet, but y'all plan on taxpayers' money. It ain't coming out of your pocket, it's coming out of ours.
Well, Ms. Solomon, again, if once this is settled and everybody can see what has been done, I think the consensus would be that there's been good faith efforts on both sides.
Okay.
Okay.
You say you created jobs out here on District 4. I have created, we've got two new businesses out there the last few years, one this year. We've created two new jobs and plan on two more before the end of the year.
That's one.
They go, yeah, they go in here doing this stuff. Just, we have a all natural beef ranch right there that we run, that we are putting our product with a label in all these stores around here. Think about it. Do you think people's going to want to eat meat that possibly could get contaminated because of well?
No.
I didn't think so.
I don't think they would.
So you tell me
that was your... Are you watering that grass out there with that well water now?
No, that's what I'm saying.
What are you using?
But what are you doing? We're using another well. But you tell me this. What are you doing whenever this runs to me again? To my another house? Where it's not contaminated.
But you have to understand.
Where my one house I live is not contaminated. When it gets to me down there, you ain't done nothing so far coming to me. What are you going to do to help? Or Forsyth County?
Well, I don't know what will be done because
okay.
I'm not there and I'm not in that.
Okay, you're supposed to be trying to help create jobs to help, you know, pick up the economy here. I'm busting my butt to get some created, start a new business, everything else, and you should be as a commissioner trying to help with that.
Why don't we schedule a meeting in tomorrow with your attorney and ours, and I guarantee you we can settle this. And
with then, our lawsuit? Hey, I'm all for it.
Because I can sit down with you. I can do it. Because
well, you also told me you'd call me after you read it, and you never did.
Well, I'm not supposed to. And
but
I
you
have
told
to also,
me you would.
Well, I have read it.
You
but
told
also
me
know
you
that
would,
there's some other
out
issues that we have to look at.
I know that.
There's a lot of
you
things
you always do
going
that to
on.
Me.
Robin, let's don't make
can
this.
I
no, you're
making
the lawsuit issue, and I'm not going
to
close the public here.
Can we get back on the...
Yeah, that's what we need to
be.
This was the fear I had.
No, no, Commissioner Bell, we understand and we'd like to keep it focused on what it needs to be focused on. Yeah.
Okay. The only thing I can tell you is I've looked at this. I'm looking at it. I'm looking at EPD to give some direction. I'm looking at our planners to give us direction. I'm looking at our water department to give us direction and solid waste about all the concerns. And the only thing I can tell you is if there's going to be a problem, I'm not going to recommend it, period. That's all I can tell you. Now, if you want to know what I'm going to do in 20 years, I hope to God I'm retired in 20 years. All right? I don't know what's going to happen in 20 years. I don't know what's going to happen if there's a plague of locusts come through here and eat all your crops.
So
I can't answer that.
You
but what I can tell you is I will protect you today, and as long as I'm in office, I will look out for you. I don't care what you've been told. I don't care what stories have been spun. I will look out for you, period.
Now, is the vote... For this, isn't it? Didn't I read something about July?
We can postpone it so we can get through this meeting.
Okay, but is there going to be enough time to do this testing to
I'll
find
probably
out
postpone
about?
It again.
Okay.
Until we get to a point where I'm comfortable that moving forward is okay, or then it doesn't need to move forward, one way or another.
And can you explain to the group here? Is that your prerogative? Can it be postponed for as long as you want to have it postponed?
I'm not sure. There is some time frames.
There's some time frames under the code, and he'll be given a lot of discretion as the commissioner.
Okay. There is some time frames that trigger that if we don't do anything.
Right.
But I believe, I know that you guys had some trouble. I guess some of them did involve with that for a long time. I know that there's always been contention with the landfill operator, whether it was the previous operator, whether it was this operator, or whatever. I can tell you that I do believe, and I feel comfortable, that they're trying to comply with every law and every request and every concern.
Because of the vote coming up or because because they have to get this?
They're too big of a company to be playing. They're not going to play with their reputation. They're a huge company. They're not going to come into Forsyth County and try to play games and sneak something through. It's too much.
Because we're a small group that live out there now. If Windermere was across the street from Eagle Point, or the Polo Club, or something like that, they would probably be a lot more in compliance. But look at this room.
I'm not so sure. We've got issues with sewer plants and those communities that are just as concerning.
But okay. Some of the things I think it slides through because
I don't believe they're that kind of company.
I do.
I do too.
Can you tell me, are they still a mining in zoning now? They passed a thing for no mining in the county a few years back.
Yes, we did.
Tell us about still.
I don't know.
Is that not the request that they requested?
Yes,
the zoning
permit. This is M-I-N-E.
It says it on the sign, does it not? It is even abbreviated.
I understand.
But why? Okay, but then how?
Well, because it's. I talked to the director about that today. Because if you own the property and you want to degrade it to plant a pasture or some blueberry bushes or whatever you want to do with it, you'd simply get an LDP and build a land disturbance permit and go on about your business. Because this is a long term, and that's exactly what we're talking about, this time frame, 6 year is what he has. The land disturbance is not incidental to the end goal. The land disturbance is the goal. So that he made a determination, and I agree with him, that land disturbance is the goal, that it needs to go into that classification. If it were just simply part of getting to the end game, building homes, building a pasture, or just flatten it out because you want a pea patch, it's a whole different process. It really is the right thing. It's the toughest way to go. It's a very good thing that he did and he made that decision because it puts it under this type of scrutiny to make sure that it's done right.
Who made this decision?
Our director decided it needed to be done under mine.
EPD, tell me, they requested.
I talked to him 2 hours ago about it.
Okay.
You know, it's one of those things that it's agricultural property. If it was your property, you can move soil out there around all you want to. You get a land disturbance permit, go to it. But you moving dirt, because you used to sell dirt to us, didn't you?
Sold dirt to you before, yeah.
That is a business or a purpose. You might have even needed to mine permit today if you were doing that. But if you were just doing it as part of getting to here, which was construction or a field or something, that's a lot different than an ongoing operation for 6 years or 8 years or whatever it is. He says six. And I agree with his philosophy on that.
One more thing, Patrick, if I may.
There we go, yeah.
When I talked to, I actually called the engineer that met with us at the community meeting.
Is that?
Mr. Stubbs, with the engineering firm down in Macon. Okay. Called him and asked him some more follow-up questions. and specifically asked him about the possible contamination flowing from the old landfill onto this property. And he said, but there is no contamination. And I said, well, how do you know? And he said, because the county hasn't told us that there's contamination. Okay, now, what it seems like we have in the county, if you ask the county, how do you know the land's not contaminated? It's because the EPD doesn't say it's contaminated. It looks like we've got foxes chasing their tails.
I want to see a report from somebody that says it's not contaminated. I don't want one agency telling
another. And that's my point.
I'm with you.
I mean, I showed you the maps. We've got the report that says that those wells on that other one map I gave you are contaminated.
What flow is dirty? I have no problem. I don't want.
And I asked the engineering company, prove to me it's not contaminated, and he couldn't do it because he was depending upon the county.
Who is the engineer? I mean, who do they represent? Forgive me, I don't
that's
know.
Harbin
Marshall
or
Stubbs, yeah.
Are they the applicant?
They were hired by Advance.
Okay, thank you. That's all I needed to know. Okay. I just was curious who they were.
Yeah, Hodges, Harbin.
Yeah, they were hired by Advance.
So we're saying the county's going to require the testing or is going to?
Well, that's just, I think.
I'm not going to pass it. I'm not going to require it, but I'm not going to suggest it to be passed unless I'm given proof that it's not contaminated.
Okay, tell me this. On this map you have here, years ago, they did the same thing with the same grandparents of these people and told them there's no way it can do this and do that. Now, are you going to judge by just what you read off of these maps and what these geologists tell you, the same ones that told them this wouldn't happen? And
as soon as I'm not a geologist, I'll have to.
Okay, so you're going to go by just, that's what I'm saying. We know that they've done told the county once that this wouldn't happen, and it has, is what I'm saying. So are you going to do the same thing all over again?
I'm not doing the same thing as anything.
It's Forsyth County. Let me rephrase
well,
that.
It really wasn't because those landfills were owned by a private company. I think they're owned by the Grovins. It may be the Mills. Grovins
Mills or something. Forsyth County
Eagle Point, a private company?
Eagle Point. Well, I think it's a private company owned by a public company.
It's an out-of-state
but my
company.
Point is that we're supposed to trust Eagle Point. A private company in the past has done the same thing.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. You can't always trust those private companies, can you?
Yeah.
You ought to go back and look at the history of that, who the owners really were.
Yeah.
That'd be an interesting concept.
And you were just telling me that Eagle Point is trustworthy and that they wouldn't use
it. I believe they are. I don't think that they're in a position, you know, an individual can go bankrupt and just leave or abandon it or just not answer it and duck it and evade it and all that kind of stuff. You're talking about a company, they're owned by AIG. And they're not AIG, you know, they all this talk about their stimulus money and all that stuff. They can't afford to jeopardize it. They just can't.
Yeah.
That's the same spiel we got when the county's going to take over that landfill over there, too.
I wasn't here then, so I don't know what the spiel was.
It don't matter if he's here or not. You're taking responsibility for what went off the back then.
I have to take responsibility for it, but I can't take credit if you would hold proof of it.
I'm just telling you what it was, and I raised a lot to you. But.
And it was with individual people that owned the property out there. Wasn't it?
Yeah, Mary, as a matter of fact, it was a commissioner. Yeah,
it was a commissioner.
Yeah, we all straight up there.
Yeah. It was, do you know the families that owned it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's interesting to know.
Yeah.
So, you know, maybe somebody ought to go talk to them. Because I wasn't involved in that. What
yeah,
I'm telling you is
talk to him,
today right? is 2012. Okay, it's not 1995. It's like Indy, Georgia, where people did what they wanted to do, as we all know they did. It's not that way anymore.
But y'all put
this
a baby
is a
over in my lap, and I'm not having a birthday every day, so.
Look, the county hired an independent testing agency to confirm yay or nay whether it's polluted or not. Are they going to depend on the landfill engineers? Seems like they're.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know.
The third party that's linked to it, we've tested
I'm not sure that we would hire them, because I'm not interested in spending taxpayer money on it. If they want to get it done, then they need to spend their money.
But then again, why should we believe that this company that wants this and can make millions off of this whole landfill,
yeah,
why would we believe that they're going to tell us the people they hire and pay just like the people you hire to test the water at our
I guess we could all be skeptical with anybody we talk to. We go deal with an insurance agent. Is he selling us the right product? Is the car salesman selling us a good used car, or has it really been wrapped? I don't know. Yeah, I don't know the answers to those things. But when you have companies that are permitted and certified and they do all of their continuing education and they're licensed and all that, you know, what am I supposed to do? Not trust them? Or do
I
use my own
I guess they can just be like me and Terry and my family. We just sit out there and we'll pay for all their mistakes.
I don't want you to pay for it.
That's what we've been doing, Patrick.
I don't think that the county should pay for the testing.
Yeah,
that's right. And neither should
I.
Neither should these people.
Do you think the landowner, would they have an interest in testing that?
Absolutely. They have more interest in this, I think, than we do. We just have a zoning issue, right? Doesn't the EPD really?
They have a big issue. A very big issue.
Well, they've already permitted.
I don't know if they have a big issue. Yeah, I think that.
They permitted the
But they
the
weren't aware of the situation. They weren't aware of the situation either.
I don't control the EPD. If they want to pull the permit, I guess they can, and we need to talk to them. But you got to understand, we don't have that authority. We do not have it. So, I don't know what you want me to do about EPD.
I just do not want land disturbed where I already know this land is contaminated and damaged the value of my property.
Haven't I just told you I wasn't allowed to be done?
As long as it's right here, it just shows it's safe. But we've done been through this and know it ain't, and they said it was, and they was wrong, but we're paying for them being wrong. We don't want to do that no more.
Well. What if you were put onto a municipal or a county water system? Would you be happy with that?
We've been trying to get water out there for how long, Patrick?
I'm just asking.
What do you think?
Would that solve the problem?
That will help with the problem. That's the start of the problem.
Hey, I think we probably ought to stay out of that realm. We're happy to discuss that.
Okay,
but we don't need to be discussing that here.
It's for both parties.
I agree.
But what the whole problem, if you wanted to be safe, you'd have to get that old landfill in compliance. Before you could be safe.
Forsyth County bought that property and it damaged. Forsyth, okay, tell me this. If I had something on my land that was going to poison my neighbor here, would Forsyth County not step in and make me clean it up? No, because they wouldn't have to, because I have enough respect for my neighbor to do so. That's why. That's the difference between me and Forsyth County right there. I'm so fed up with that crap, it ain't funny.
How's the county getting by without not chasing their contamination that's leaving their property? That's a law that you're supposed to be doing. Isn't that right? Just because the same way you stay out of compliance, just do what you want to do, right?
No, I wouldn't suggest that.
How does the EPA?
You know, I've been telling people for a long time, they're very responsible.
Commissioner, I mean, we can't, and I don't mean to be disrespectful at all. All of y'all are making great comments, and I know that it's heartfelt, but I can't let him answer these questions. Let's go directly to causation. It's impending litigation. And I do apologize. I mean, with all due respect.
I hate to tell you this situation deals with that. That's all I'm going to tell you.
Yes, sir, and I understand.
It's all public record.
Yes, sir.
So why can't we talk about it if it's public record? I don't understand that.
Well, go ahead. There's a difference. The issue of causation is at the very core of your litigation. That's part of the case, is my point. And that's not a matter of public record. There's no finding on that.
Finding on?
On causation. That's the fundamental element of the case, of our litigation. And I mean that. And I know you all believe.
Explain to me what that is again. What's your fundamental point of your case?
The link between what is going on your property and the origin of where it comes from is one of the issues in your case that
that's
is currently.
That's no issue. It's already
that's
a public
in
record. I know, but that's a factual determination to be made. The only point that he's making is that's something that gets resolved.
Oh, it just can't be talked about.
Yes, ma'am. That's all I'm saying. I know that y'all feel very strongly about that.
It's
our home.
I'm not here to argue with them about the merits of their case or the county's case. I sympathize with them. Well, as an individual, I said,
will the results of this action be made public? Will we all know about what the outcome is?
At some point or the other, yes, sir.
Was you notified when they could ask for this request by mail? Was any of y'all besides me and Terry? Was you
the
right
zoning
across
application?
The street? That's right. You was right across the street?
Yes, because it was adjacent landowners.
Me and you are the only one that was.
Why don't you guys give me your address? There's a list that we maintain of concerned property owners, and you'll get notification on everything.
Well,
that's the county's job to take care of, make sure that people around them is notified.
You got to give me your address.
That ain't even your job.
I can't just pop it out of thin air here. You got to at least give me your address, and I'll take care of it.
What happens if we're not concerned with the fact that, you know, it's not?
That you just feel that it's not?
Yeah, if it's not. I mean, is there anything we can do about it?
Falsely.
That's about it.
I guess. Is that
I'm sorry, I didn't hear the question.
Well, she says if we do the test, the tests are done, everything appears to be okay. I'm not saying it will be, but say that everything looks like it is. Mm-hmm. And she says, what if we're still not comfortable with that? What's the remedy?
Well,
the only remedy I know is litigation. Right?
Well, I think there's a difference between not being comfortable with it and there being some objective damage to the property. If there's really objective damage on the property, then unfortunately the civil courts.
So you
yes,
ma'am.
And you can't afford the testing because we're talking thousands of dollars every month.
That's my point. So, I mean, why would I agree to do this?
Because you need to ask them to do it.
Eagle Point's
that's not your responsibility.
Well, I'm just thinking about he said the county can't assure us that.
And
hopefully the best source of the resource there would be the EPD if they could determine that it is or
and
isn't contaminated.
It's not, nobody's.
These companies that are authorized, permitted, licensed to perform these tests are licensed by the state, the same as an engineer's license by the state or your doctor's or anybody else. Now, does that mean that it's a perfect system?
No.
but it doesn't mean that they go hire the cousin from Arkansas to come and say that he's a tester. You know, you have to be licensed by the state, and we can certainly specify that it has to be a licensed firm.
And we can
take all those measures. Can I promise you that nothing's going to happen? Sure.
Do you feel like there'll be a resolution to everyone's satisfaction before this is approved?
If we are not comfortable, if I'm not comfortable, that the questions have been answered, all of them tell us, I'm comfortable.
Can we see that before?
Of course.
Then? Will they have another meeting and then they'll show us exactly what's tested for?
I don't know. I guess we can require them to have another public participation.
Is that only your decision? Or is that everybody's?
I'm only one-fifth of a board of commissioners. It takes three to do anything.
So
anything that I want to do, I go to my board and I say,
okay, that's what I need to do.
Will you go along with me on this?
Okay.
Usually, 9 times out of 10, unless it's, you know, right before campaign season, they go along with it. Okay.
And the other question is, will they have results to the test when they do that? So everyone can see and hear the wine that means, you know, the test done by the EPD and other Eagle Point.
Same. You want to see the results?
I'll ask the results before I go through.
I think that would put everybody.
That's fair. If the
results are negative.
Water is the biggest,
biggest
thing that concerns us. Not the soil as much, but the water.
Well, the air. Because when they go in there digging, we was
right across the
street.
He can
hear
one.
No, I'm comfortable with that. I'm comfortable with having another meeting if they don't want
to.
So can we leave you a list of the email
events?
I've heard you correctly offered to provide results, testing results. I have my own results, and I got a good meeting. You know, if there's anything in addition, I'm guessing you're going to have the same thing, or maybe whatever you find.
Some of the things I'm not sure about. You know, there are laws, and I don't know if they apply here or not, but there's certain laws that some of these uses have. The state has laws that prevent us from doing certain things as well. So I've got to look at some of those things.
Let me ask you something. If for some reason the state has a law that prevents us from saying anything,
No.
I just want to make sure.
There's some, and I'm not trying to quote it all, so don't think this is the gospel. There's a state law that talks about landfills and stuff that you can't, you've got to have a, just trying to think, there's some state laws that prevent county governments from doing certain things. Yeah.
The county government from acting.
From acting because they know that local governments have pressure and, there is some laws in the landfill.
I think that may be part of what it concerns everyone.
If that's the case, then
the county's benefiting from this transaction. It's paranoia, I understand that to a degree.
Maybe we need to get, we'll look at that. I'll find out what those laws are. If we need to get the state reps in to talk to you guys, I'll do that. I'll invite them to come in. I'm telling you, it's not going to be done unless I'm comfortable.
Oh, I know. There's going to be some errors out.
We'll do everything within our power to make sure that it's done right. If we're not, it won't go. If we let it go, we've done the best we can with your time. I know that's what people want to hear. Well, I can't. I can't promise you there's not going to be a wildfire out there and burn everything down.
Well,
I just can't.
This is something that can make something to be done.
No, what I can promise you is I will do everything within our power to ensure that it's done properly and that it's done safe. That I can promise you. And that's all I can learn from.
Now tell me, do we have any problem as far as your involvement with the Eagle Point landfill? Because I do know that you are involved with that group of people up there, friend-wise. Are we going to have a problem with that? So you're going to be able to step back from all that, even the campaign contributions?
No, I know that's your
contribution. So we don't, none of us have to worry about nothing.
You don't have to worry about mine, Tech.
That's what I'm wanting to make sure.
You don't have to worry.
That's why I'm asking you tonight.
Because to say I don't answer to the voters on the technical, I answer to God.
That's right.
You have to understand
that's
that.
That's exactly right.
And people can say what they want. I've done nothing while I've been on the board, and I will never do anything ever that crosses that line. That I just promise you.
Yeah, because you only have him to look at that.
You're absolutely right. Right. And I can promise you, I'm not going to cross him for a landfill. Yeah. Okay? And every commissioner's gotten just about the same amount of money from me.
No, I just want to make sure it's not going to be an issue.
Every commissioner or your state
I mean, I just don't want no back scratching going on here like back in the 80s did.
Because I know,
there
I'd
again,
love to be able
in Forsyth County, there
I'd
again,
love to be able to tell you about
I
that.
Know it, but if Forsyth County was so up and up and up to date like you claim to be, I wouldn't be having to watch everything I say right now.
I don't believe in the 80s it was.
Well, whenever it was, I wasn't there then. Me and Terry was not even knew each other then. I couldn't tell you, I've talked to him about that. I'm just his wife now that's trying to protect what he's worked his butt off for and his family and his
grandparents. The families that own that property and all that went on with it, you wouldn't be upset with me. You'd be upset with somebody else.
I don't know all that situation. And that's why I don't want it to
happen. There's nothing I can do about that.
I don't want it to happen again.
I can promise you, I'm not going to do what they did.
I just don't want it to happen again. And I don't care.
Not through me, Ms. Solomon.
Well, I'm just making sure.
And I'm not trying to sell property. This doesn't benefit me in the least little bit. And if you think
this benefits me and
of,
my family,
it sure does.
Every which
but if
way.
You think that a $2,000 contribution means that I'm going to sacrifice my morals and integrity,
and I hope it don't are millions of dollars of property either.
Well,
so that's what I'm getting at.
Again, let's keep it focused
okay.
on what we need
okay.
to be focused
I'm
on.
I'm here to help all of you.
That's what we want to hear.
Yeah.
So, all right, you go home like that.
Sorry?
Can I go home with you? What, you want to whoop up on me in the car?
No. No.
I'm afraid of you, Terry. You know that.
Is there anybody else you want to add to it that I need to try to track down?
It's
not your
time.
How are you?
No, I can do that. I'll put the
contact. Trust me, I've been giving them your information. They'll be contacting me. I've been giving them all that. They have your emails and everything.
Well, make sure that they contact me and give me their information, because if they don't, they're not going
to
know.
Well, I will ask them to. I already have.
Okay. What's the lady?
I'll ask them again.
Linda.
Yeah. I think she's working out of town or something. I never did reach her.
I didn't try yet. Robin, you probably just ought to, y'all as a group ought to take that upon yourselves, I think, to make your neighbors aware. And
oh, I already did all that. I knocked on everybody's door.
But I think you provide
Solomon,
him with the
I'm
list he's requested.
If
and
they don't contact me, right. I don't know who they are.
That's fair enough.
I know.
And they're not gonna
that's why I told them this. They had to speak
what
out.
What you're saying is you get the list, everybody will get noticed. That's,
yeah.
That's fair.
Yeah.
That's fair enough.
That's all I need.
I will give them, you know, I've done all that. Oh, I can't make them write it.
Well, no, that's true. If you tell me that you've given me everybody
this lady right back here helped me also.
I have a question because I did attend the public participation meeting that they had at Sony Mountain, and the consultants that Advanced Disposal hired they had many more maps than even that, and they gave their presentation, and they were very clear about the number of acres that were going to be used and how far they were going to dig down and for how long the hole would be open, because I asked the question, could it possibly be that they could do the reclamation of the property in phases so people wouldn't have to look at a big gaping 36 to 40 foot hole for 14 or 15 years? And it worries me that they made that presentation to these people, and now what you're presenting is totally different.
I can just go by what this says right here.
But,
I don't know what they said.
But why did they present one thing to these people and now they're doing something different with the county?
Yeah, this is nothing.
You have to ask them. I don't know.
But I think that's something that would be of concern to you as well.
What I can tell you is everything that they've told me is pretty much contained in here.
Can they do
there's
it in phases?
There's 71.67.
Could they be asking if they're asking now to the county, we're only going to do 48 acres in 6 years, and then come back at year five and say, well, we're just kidding, we're now wanting to go another 8 years?
So you know how land zoning goes, you've been involved with it. If you own a piece of property that's agricultural today, and you believe that a good use is going to be residential, and you come in and you get it rezoned to residential, right? You're happy, everybody's happy, you go on about your business. Then you decide 6 years later, that residential didn't quite pan out like I wanted. I need to do commercial, right? You've been involved with that.
But that wasn't what
they can come back. They will come
that
back in,
they
and they will come
no,
back in.
Not.
I'm fairly certain, and ask for more dirt.
We all heard.
You're asking me if they can do it in phases, and I'm telling you they can come in at any time, just like anybody can come in and ask for a zoning and as long as it complies with the law, they can ask for it.
I'm asking you why the company hired a consultant and had a public participation meeting where they are giving the public, the landowners, the neighbors, supposed to be true information that they can discuss and get truth from their consultants. And now, a few weeks later, they come before you and they're getting a totally different presentation.
Well, I can't answer what they did, Ms. Mills. I'm not responsible for that.
But these people need somebody to be responsible.
I only make my decision on what's here. I don't care what they told anybody. Here's what I make the decision on.
But you should care. If they're telling people lies and no truths, you should care.
No,
I've said that.
I make my decision on what's on their application, what our staff prepares, what is analyzed, what is looked at, and I don't make it on hearsay. I don't make it on a PowerPoint presentation. I make it on this. That's all I can do.
These people didn't hire that company. Advanced Disposal hired them. It's not hearsay if every one of them heard it.
I go with what's right here.
Okay, well then we know that's not correct. Either that or someone.
This is what I'll be making a decision on.
Action, they got plenty of money to get you a piece of paper like that and do all that work for you.
This is our report.
I don't care. They got plenty of money to fill that piece of paper out.
This is what.
And all we got is a voice and a taxpayer's money that pays your bills.
I don't care what they told you, Ms. Sullivan. This is what we'll make the decision on.
But why would they pay a company to come in and sit down and rent a building and tell us a lie? There again, we're supposed to trust this company? I don't think so.
I can't tell you why they did something.
Well, you need to find that out. As Commissioner number four, find that out first, please.
73 acres. No, I'm telling you, 73 acres with 41.69 is affected. That's what the decision's made on.
That's not what they
told us. And it's 6 years. That's the decision.
They told us 15 years, Patrick.
So do you want me to go with their 15 or 6? Which one do you want?
Did they tell us?
You want 15 or 6?
I can't go by that. I'm going by this company that says they're going to destroy.
This is what I will make the decision on, and this is what will be entered into the record.
Okay. Well, I'm just telling you what they brung us out.
Then call them and ask them why. But I go
by
what we
have. They won't talk to us. They will not talk to us.
I go by what is the official record. I don't go by any of that. Okay? It's 6 years here. It's 41.69 acres here.
Yeah, and then, but you know what it is? Here's what it is. Is that's their little foot in the door, and then they'll go in and ask for the other, 9 years left, and then throw trash in that hole that they're going to dig for 15 years, Patrick. I know what their plan is. If that wasn't their plan, they would have never rented a building, hired a big company, a geologist, to come out there and try to convince us it's safe.
So what do I do?
I think that might have been what Ms. Mills asked you a few minutes ago. Was that going to be a condition put on that they couldn't
dig? I'm going to put a condition that they can't use it for trash. But I think the EPD has that type of stuff under control.
No, EPD.
They're the ones that regulate the footprints of these things.
You know that, Patrick.
We don't regulate the footprint of landfills. We regulate
landfills. That was not even in the footprint. That was left out because Cherokee County was doing that.
I don't know what you guys want me to do.
We just want you to help us get this where it's safe for our.
Have I not said that maybe a dozen times?
I know, but see, you're telling us something, then they told us something different. So you're telling us
that.
No, wait a minute. You're telling us this. They told us 15 years. You stood here 15 minutes ago telling this young lady here how she needs it. They're a very dependable, trustworthy company. But yet you're standing here telling me that you're showing me something different they told me, and I'm supposed to believe you or them. Which one?
I'm going to go
either
by this. This is all I'm allowed to go by.
I know.
And this
and
is better for you.
And that's the problem. You go by a piece of paper when you don't know the real what's going on out there.
This is better for you, Ms. Sullivan.
Commissioner, what?
What happens to the big hole once they have this big hole? What are they going to do?
Grass and plant trees in it.
In a hole?
In a hole.
No. In a hole?
No, they will not fill it with garbage. I'll put conditions
in a hole
that they can't.
That's good. I think everybody was concerned about that.
I've already addressed that. There will be conditions put on that they can't put trash in.
They do a lot of pit stuff out there too, where they pour some pretty contaminated stuff in a pit and pour a little salt or some matter. Well, I'm just telling you. And this is what the whole conversation, I think my wife and Ms. Bills have been trying to tell you, is we're citizens. We're here to talk to you, right?
You are.
But if we don't put something on that piece of paper right there, you're not going to listen to us.
No.
What you're just saying.
No, I'm listening to your concerns.
I'm just telling you that they dig a pit.
How about letting me answer your question, Mr. Solomon?
You didn't let me finish my question.
If you're going to keep asking me questions, why don't you at least let me answer? Would that be fair?
Well, I finished my question.
I don't think so.
But listen, let him answer, then you can answer.
Wait, I asked a question here.
Just let him respond. Go ahead. Let him respond.
What I'm saying is they dig pits out there and they pour some pretty contaminated stuff in this stuff and they let it evaporate up into the air, okay? How do we know they ain't gonna use this for that? You know? Well, I know it. Well, I knew that's what
you're
going to say.
You're asking me to answer a lot of speculative questions about an industry that's very technical, and I can't answer them.
I can't answer
what's going to happen in 10, 15, 20, 50, or 100 years.
I've been around. I've seen.
You're asking me to make decisions. Let me please finish my answer.
Go.
Is that okay?
Go.
You're asking me to answer a lot of questions about what went on in the 70s and 80s and what's going to go on in 20, 30, 35, or 40. And I can't do that. And I'm not going to do it. And it's not evading your question. It would be irresponsible for me to try to answer those.
Well, all right. And let me ask you this. And as long as you've been around zoning, and I've been around it, and everybody else has been around it, nobody does one thing but they don't have a reason to back up on it, okay? And what, you know, that is the question. That is the million-dollar question. What's going to happen next?
I don't know. I know it happens. I know people ask for zonings to go to a res 2 or R2, and then they come in and they want a little this and a little bit of that. I mean, we've seen that. I understand that. But I can't deny somebody something based on what they might do in the future.
That's understandable.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
I know there's people, a lot of us that lives around the dump. There's a lot of people that live there on the Yellow Creek Road like I do. All right, there's some of it that it'll come our way and we can smell it and we can't even get on the outside. And we've got a lot of us has got several kind of diseases like COPD, diabetes, cancer and other stuff. Well, that ain't good for us when all this here stuff comes in on us. And what, like Terry says, what is they gonna put in that hole and it comes out there, and is it gonna give us something other else?
Well, according to what they presented here, says here that they'll be reclaimed the grasslands, shrubs, ponds, and pine trees.
Well, that ain't gonna absorb all of that odor that's gonna come from.
No, but they're not gonna put more trash in, is what I'm saying. The odor is regulated in itself. The borrow pit here, I don't believe it's gonna make a difference with the odor. Now, if there's an issue with the odor, I need to talk to you about it, and I'll look into it. But this particular, they're digging some dirt.
Sometimes the odor comes up, way on up the Yellow Creek Road.
I talk to people all the time over there in the Hamptons, so I know what you mean.
Yes.
Always Saturday and Sunday, y'all.
And late of the evening, the odor gets so bad that we have to shut the door.
Well, I would like to talk to you about that. I look into it, but that doesn't have anything to do with them moving dirt.
Can I ask
another
question?
It is an issue that needs to be looked into.
It's what there already is existing.
Right.
During the week, it does okay because we don't smell it, but when they go home on the weekends, see, they can leave it in a cover, and they don't bother them, but when they're working, they don't leave it in a cover. They, on the weekends, that's the problem. That's been going on for years, and
yeah,
I complain.
Like I said,
everybody.
They leave it uncovered on the weekends.
They leave it uncovered on the weekends, and everybody smells it. It comes in our homes. We can close our doors and it still comes in our doors. Yeah, can't open our windows. Can't have people.
EPD?
Yes, EPD. I have complained to the county. I complained to Eagle Point Landfill. They tell me not to call. That's what they tell me. They tell us not to call.
Okay.
They don't want to hear us.
Well,
you think there's such a good running? It does matter.
No, what I'm saying is it doesn't. They're going to have to hear you.
Well, that's the problem. They're
so
not.
If there's
they
a
don't
problem,
care.
I've never heard about the odor problem.
Well,
I've had one guy that calls me.
I have complained, Patrick, and complained.
To me?
Patrick, you don't call me back, for one.
I call everybody.
How can I complain when you won't even return a phone call?
Well, every one of my phone calls are logged. Do you want to tell me when you called, and I'll go back and look and see?
Oh, let's stop.
Because I've returned every phone call. Might be slow, but I do call back.
Can I ask a question that's unrelated to this?
But I'll look into the odor issue. That doesn't really relate to this, but I will look into it.
Well, it's one of the problems.
I just called over some of the diseases that people ask out up there, and it don't help matters none.
I know it doesn't. And then I'll look into it, and I'll look into it being uncovered over the weekends or whatever they have to be in compliance.
All you can do is go over Saturday, and you'll see exactly what we're talking about.
Or when it rains?
Yeah.
When it rains, it's really
bad. It's really
bad. But here's the other thing, and who do we contact to complain about this? And it may not bother the rest of you as much as it does me, but I wash my car, I wax my car, I get it nice and clean. The garbage trucks pull out of the landfill with the nasty mud from the landfill, and they drive up Old Federal, and the road's wet, and I come along behind them, and my car looks like I went four-wheeling.
Oh,
it's nasty, it stinks, and...
Walker Brown, my husband.
You know what I suggested at this last meeting we had when you... Actually, Pete was there, but he went there. That's what I suggested from Eagle Point Landfill. Instead of going around giving everybody fruitcakes every Christmas to give everybody a year's supply of car washes and windshields. Because every windshield we have is broke by the truck.
Is there somebody that we can take that up with? Because, I mean, like, for example, the dump trucks at the quarry, C.W. Matthews, the rock quarries, they have tire washers. And the trucks are coming out of the quarry with all this dust on them, and they have to drive through this thing that sprays water on their wheels to clean them before they pull out on the road. Because, you know, we got the quarry right across from the hospital.
Right.
Roads are always clean coming out of there. You know, can we, who, how do we go about trying to enforce something to get them to do something? Because it's bad.
I don't know if there's any.
I'm pretty sure they are bad.
They don't use it.
Well, that, okay. I can't speak for that.
Ken, is there any?
They never have.
But people actually, get the road started. I mean, other than we encourage them to be a good neighbor and look into, I'll talk to them about that. But.
Right. Well, I mean, there are regulations with respect to covering your loads and things of that nature. Now, kicking up debris, that's a tough one. I mean, that is
I thought there was some regular
are
there state
well,
law.
I know coming about tires or something onto the road. Or?
Well, I know if we're hauling dirt in a subdivision, they're building a new house, we pull out of there and we track the roads. We get in trouble for that. We have to clean up behind ourselves. So how is it the landfill doesn't have to and they dirty up Old Federal?
Are you dealing with the developer then?
It's
DOT.
It's a regular, yeah.
It is DOT in a subdivision?
If you're
it's the law. I don't know it's just right. The law. I mean, you're supposed to clean
it's a county ordinance guy, so it is, yeah.
Yeah. So, you know.
I don't believe there's a county ordinance.
Who's the ordinance policeman? Coming enforcement?
Code enforcement.
I'm wondering if it's an agreement that you have with the developer that you're doing work with.
I don't know. All I know is we have to, you know, if we track mud
that's
out
I'm thinking
the road and stuff like that, we
they
want to
keep it clean.
In trouble.
Well, you can now you can get in trouble for, you know, basically it's a variation on sedimentation. You start tracking all that dirt out, that they basically.
Well,
they equate that to runoff. Is what
that's
they,
how we
because then
well,
when it rains
maybe.
And it runs off in the Edel right there,
maybe that's the way we look at it.
Well, they're supposed to. I mean, there's regulations that affect that. They're supposed to wet down their loads and try to minimize the dust. I mean, that's
coming off the tires.
They're also supposed to keep it when they come out of the entrance. They, you know, when they're about 5-6 years ago, they did a very good job. When we, you know, I was complaining hard because I'm not kidding. I drove out, my windshield got broke. Next week, I went back out, got broke again. I mean, I got tired of spending $300-$400 every week, every other week. Terry went and bought a brand new 2006. In 2006, ask him how long he went before his windshield was broke. Every one of us.
Hey, I got the chip man. I got a free windshield coming too.
That's how bad it is.
Yeah, the chip man's got a free one coming.
It's real convenient to laugh about, but you know, it gets very costly. And you know that, Larry.
I wasn't laughing, just the record your lawyer.
We're all
I know what you're doing.
But
I'm serious, it's rough.
This is state ground, and I can
certainly.
Did you look into that? Because it is really dangerous. I wish they would put a light.
Let me tell you, we did that. Terry went up there to talk to him, and they threatened to have him locked up. And I told him not to ever go back again. No, listen. He went up there to talk to them about that several years ago, and you know what she had to say? You leave or we're having you arrested and don't come back. Now, he was going to go to get arrested because we are a concerned neighbor with an issue, and only thing we get back is you leave or we're going to have you locked up. And I told Terry, don't you ever go back up there again. They're not for us. It's all about their bill phones. They're not even an in-state company. They're from Florida. Yeah, and reaping all the business.
Cherokee is just realigning the other end, 369, 20.
Maybe they can do something to the road where you can see. It's really dangerous. Or maybe even stick a turn lane there or something. I don't know.
I agree. It's very dangerous. I'm on the road all the time, and you're right. I've been hit there. I mean, close to being hit there several times. I'm serious.
Yeah, I won't even let the kids drive the bus because I'm afraid that those big trucks are going to like
hit them. And people fly on including them semis. I mean, we had one of them trucks broke down a couple weeks ago right there on that. When you go past the airport up that big bank, nobody out there left a truck unattended, not a soul out there, just left it in it dark for people to come over and just run into it head on. A gray truck on a gray highway. I called 911 and asked them to get someone out to direct traffic. I mean, should I have to be doing that? No, I should not. We should have been able to just call Eagle Point Landfill and say, look, one of your trucks is broke down here, but if I do that, I get threatened.
I would have called the sheriff's office as well. I would have called Eagle Point.
Well, that's who I called.
Yeah. The sheriff's office?
I could, yes.
That's who you should have called.
That's who I called. I reported. But they sent someone out there to take care of it.
Absolutely.
But that's just one of the, I mean, it's every day out there. Every day there's something. It's stuff poured on the ground.
The dirt off the road or the trucks running you off the road.
Or stuff that's spilt and stinks all and gets slung on our cars. Let me tell you, I had one of my actual vehicle I still have now. When they was hauling that, what you call sewage from Alpharetta. And they were spilling it all up and down Old Fredsville Road. Yeah. It got into my car. We thought something was wrong with my car. We took it and got it worked on it. And they said all it was all that crap underneath where it tainted on my Cadillac inverter, our whole system, where I drive that road and it just keeps popping back up there and build up. And if they was keeping it clean, I wouldn't have that build up on my car. I mean, that's pretty bad to affect someone's vehicle. And we're talking SUV, Tahoe, a tough car.
One of the other last concerns that I'll mention that hasn't been mentioned yet, and it's hesitate to mention it because it assumes that the zoning application is approved. But if it is approved, the other concern that we have then is dust. You know, talking if you're clearing a large area, anybody down there is going to be caked in dust. The lady mentioned here about the respiratory issues. I don't know what can be done. I don't even know if there's a jurisdiction for free floating dust. You know, is it an EPD issue? I don't know.
There's dust, but that floats off the hill as it is. You guys obviously.
We get a lot of it where we are.
Are you talking about dust by way of the soil disturbance?
Yeah. Yes, clearing a large area like that.
You can condition that. You can condition
that. I don't know how you treat it. There's got to be a technique. I would think, hopefully, there's a technique we can prescribe. I don't know if that's enough. Maybe they have to cover it every night. Yeah.
You're putting that down, too, though, for one of our things, right? Because that's very important.
My understanding is hauling will be done on the property.
Yes, it is. Right. But just the disturbing.
But still, it's going to blow.
You get a wind blow, you get a.
The wind's going to blow. I mean, just about when it cools down and we got the wind blowing toward us, it's going to blow, especially with the lack of rain.
Yeah, and I don't see any employees out there picking berries and dust flying all over the place. We're talking, this is within feet to my. $20,000 again I spent to create a new business for Forsyth County and jobs. Now, you tell me, how is that going to take off? 1,500 blueberry plants out there, Patrick.
It really doesn't seem like Eagle Point is a whole lot for people who live around them. It seems like
they get by with the bare minimum, and that's not it. We've all been there, we've done that, we've called people in the very beginning, and it just, you know, I've called the EPD before.
To be fair, Mr. Bell, if we have a complaint, we need to.
You need to call him, absolutely. He'll call us in a minute.
He will.
He will, and it's okay, that's my job, I don't mind doing it. I know that it gets frustrating, and I know that you guys are not losing time, there are always issues, some are just apparent to the business, they can't be avoided, some can be, some they can just be a bad neighbor, they're making up required, but they can be. And I have to tell you, Ms. Solomon, I'm not trying to insinuate you're not, but I got one man that calls me, who lives in Edgewood Trails.
Oh, I hear that, yeah.
He calls me about every 3 or 4 months, and we go out, we check, and I send code enforcement out, and we look at it. That's the only person that's ever.
Why is he complaining?
What, did it do any good? You say he calls you all the time, so did it do any good?
Well, I got people calling me from about the chicken plant, too.
But there again, Patrick, this is not a chicken plant. You know this is a serious issue, again.
No, it's an odor issue.
Okay, did you do anything, take a step to do anything to check it out?
They do, and they monitor it. I don't go out and check air quality.
Then why should we call and complain to you?
Well, don't. Just sit at home and gripe about it.
No, but that's just what I'm saying. Why should, we need to complain to people that's going to hear us and going to help us, not people that ain't going to.
If you've never, do you want me to come out there and test it myself? Is that what you want me to do?
No, I do not.
So what do you want? If we have a complaint and we call you.
I don't know what you want.
You just sat here and said, if we got a complaint, call you. And then you just sat there and tell her, you know, well, oh, I ain't going to, I mean, I can't do anything about it. So what did you do when he, this man calls you?
I call code enforcement, I will call the landfill, I will call EPD.
Did you do that when this other man said?
Of course I did.
Okay, that's all I asked, that's all I asked, why blow it up to a big situation?
Because if he calls you every 4 months, and obviously the EPD and all of them.
They're in compliance, just like the chicken plant, they're in compliance.
But the landfill's not, right?
As far as odor goes.
We're talking about.
But we're talking about compliances too, so it fits in there with you.
I'm talking about odor.
Well, it stinks, I'll tell you that right now.
I bet it does.
Yeah.
You can smell the chemicals in it, Patrick, you can smell them chemicals in it. Can y'all smell them?
Aren't they supposed to keep something on to keep the smell away?
They're burning the.
They put the flame in the burn.
But is that supposed to stay on?
It has helped.
If I'm just gonna figure the problem, then I, you know, I'll look into it and learn a little bit more about it. I got one man called me every 3 or 4 months, every 6 months. Just call the appropriate fee, and then he calls me again in 6 months. I mean, but as far as I've always been told, they're in compliance.
So like, if somebody were to go and get pictures on the weekend where trash is uncovered, and you got proof.
Send it to them.
We have pictures.
Absolutely.
You got pictures?
A long time ago.
There you go.
We filmed them, they have them. It was uncovered, I mean, it was horrible, it was out my front window.
But the pictures from 7, 8 years, 3 years.
Well, it has to be them.
If you got them, get them to me, because in your camera or on your computer, they don't really get them, but I've got to know about it. And I'm easy to find.
All coming away from the meeting is better communications.
Yeah, so.
Well, I've got to know if I'm gonna do something, I can't, you know, do things.
We just need to know, and the right people though, really seriously.
You got one person to call.
You.
Call me.
Okay, and, well, we should be able to call more than one person.
Well, who do you want to call? I'll get you a question.
That's why I asked you a minute ago who you called, Patrick.
I just gave you the answer.
And, yeah, okay, that's why I asked you who you did call with these complaints, when someone calls and complains to you. Okay, that's what these people need to be doing too.
They need to call what they can.
Yeah.
They call anybody.
It's best thing, yeah. And you, and all of them.
Well, sure, sure, I'll get you.
But you guys really all need to speak with a unified voice. I mean, y'all all have concerns, and some people are frustrated and aren't dealing with them, some people are.
No, you don't.
Yeah, I really do.
No, you don't.
There's power, pardon me?
But you're trying to take out on me everything that's been.
No, I'm not, I'm just tired of people that just.
Well, you won't give me a chance because somebody else did something that you're not happy with. And if you want me to help you, you're gonna have to at least give me the opportunity to help you. You gonna listen?
I mean, you know, I mean, I'm listening to you.
Oh, I know, but he was talking to me, and I was trying to hear what he was saying. I was not being disrespectful.
No, no, there's no disrespect. I'm just trying to tell you, you're trying to take out on me everything that's happened to you out there.
No, I'm not. That's not true.
And you've not even given me the opportunity to try to help
you. I called you more than once.
How many times have you called me?
Let me tell you, I even
come to the office. Hey, I would like to say this real quick, is that... Well, you know, Commissioner Bell is here meeting with you guys in a public forum, and I think that's appropriate.
So why does he keep bringing it up?
Well, no, but I guess what I'm saying is...
That if you will communicate with me, Ms. Solomon, I can help you. If you sit at home and gripe about it to your neighbors, I can't help you.
You know, that's the problem. I haven't griped to my neighbors, and they all know this until this time.
You cannot... I can't help you if you don't give me the opportunity.
Because I've been told to be quiet.
By who?
Oh, Patrick, don't even go there.
I've told you I can't talk to you about litigation, but I've not told you to be quiet.
You told me at the meeting, over the phone, did you not, that if I even mentioned a well being contaminated, that you would take this county attorney and stop the meeting right then. Did you not tell me that, Patrick?
Yes, I did. Okay, absolutely. Then.
Okay.
And you said, you mean I got to bring my attorney and have to pay him to sit there and listen to you talk?
You told me that I had to bring my attorney.
That's exactly right.
You told me I had to.
That's exactly right, because we're in litigation, Ms. Solomon.
That's right. So don't say and act like I didn't want to bring my attorney.
But I did not tell you you had to be quiet. You have not called me for the 3.5 years that I've been in office more than once or twice.
Actually, I helped get you there, believe it or not.
Wait, then why didn't you call me and tell me there was a problem instead of waiting until now,
Patrick,
to tell
we
me?
Have called and called.
You have not.
We have even been in mediation with the county.
Not
so don't,
with me. Have
Patrick,
you
claimed
me?
You read my contract
on the phone. Hey, let's
I can't
let's
talk about your litigation.
Where it is,
I'm talking about the community.
He's trying to instigate this is what he's doing.
You know I talked to you, son. You know I talked to you.
How many times have you called?
Several times. You know how many times you're just going to tell me you're going to do something, you're going to do this, and you ever done it?
Every time you call me with a problem.
No.
But if it has to do with that litigation, the only option I have is to call my attorney and say, here's what's going on. That's it. That's all I can do.
But I think what you've said is that you're willing to sit down and speak with the Solomons tomorrow.
Well, I have to say that. Yes, I am. There's some other actions.
No, that's fair. But I mean,
we have to look into
but
that.
But what I'm saying is there has been a somewhat of a lack of communication, it appears to me. And you know, everybody can take their share of the blame, but at this point, there's a way to sort of try to figure this out and work forward. Exactly.
Well, that's all you know. That's all we've ever wanted.
But there's three issues. There's the litigation, which he's hamstrung to speak with you all about, and you're hamstrung, too. I get that. Then there's the zoning, which we've spent a little bit of time here talking about, but not. And then there's problems that look like ongoing with advanced that I'm very interested in hearing those as well that aren't related to the zoning, they're related to business practices is what it sounds to me.
And I have to tell you, I don't know if you've heard, but I've not heard. I have not heard from anybody.
I got an earful before.
Well, I have a question. Do you have like a business card? Do you have your number?
Trust me, people's been complaining.
So in case we do have a problem, should we call?
Well, and I will say, in Patrick's defense, he got a hold of Patrick's number when he had some other issues, and
I went out there that afternoon,
and not only did he help, he was a tremendous help on getting our road paved.
Oh, I know.
There was major roadblocks.
I know.
Even though the money was there. But then, on a personal matter, Patrick stepped in and helped Pete resolve an issue with his half-sister and the property that Bud owned and kept her from losing that property. And if Patrick wouldn't have stepped in, she'd have lost that property because it was that far gone. So he has been an advocate and helped on things, but we got to get it to him. And like that's why I asked about the road conditions, you know, especially on rainy days. Who do we go to? Now that I voiced it to you.
I'll take care of it. Well, I can't promise I will find out what we can do and what we're allowed to do, and we will. And I will talk to him about the tire washer. And that's what's good to hear from people because you know about the plant stuff because you're not in the trash business, but you're hauling stuff, you know. So I can go in there and say, now there is this stuff. And I'm happy to do so. You know, Pete called me and had a problem keeping his dump truck in his house. Our code didn't allow it. Well, I got it changed because I do care. Just call me. Now, if you're suing us, I won't be able to help you much because he's the one in control of this.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you for coming. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
I know y'all's frustrated.
Well, I had a surgeon do that.
I don't know. Yeah.
Well,
Thank you very much.
I will give you a question. You're welcome. I'll give you myself.
All right, just okay. That's the biggest. All right, so you can't.